I'm thanking him because I'm learning more to trust him in all of this. As we started out this year, I know where God took us through last year, he had us in a lot of warfare. And I have to say that when I got towards the end of last year, I was kind of like in a fog. I'm like, Lord, where are you taking us this year? You know, I've been to churches where they have themes for the year and they'll put banners up for the year, and that's just not me. You know, I like to go with, Lord, you know, you tell me which way to go, because it could be this today and tomorrow could be something different. But I know that all last year, I know he had us dealing with a lot of fighting, because I think he's really been preparing us for where he's taking us this year. You're going to have to be strong. You're going to have to really learn to fight, because the devil does not want us to go anywhere. Mm-hmm. He wants us, matter of fact, to retreat. And that is not going to be in my vocabulary. I have no plans on retreating.
Amen.
I have no plans on quitting. I have no plans on going back. I don't care if it's just me standing up preaching to the empty walls. I'm going to do what God said do, because he loves me and he takes care of me, and I'm learning to be obedient to his word. So one of the things that he started to tell me at the beginning of this year is, you need to have your faith encouraged. You need to start working on your faith. Now, he's telling me this, and I'm like, Lord, I got faith. Now he's like, no, you need to start really working on your faith, because it's going to take a great power of faith for you to go where I'm taking you. You're going to have to trust me. You're going to have to listen to me. You're going to have to abide by my rules. You have to abide by my word. And I went, okay, Lord, whatever you say. So I know this is how God has started us out to this year, dealing with our faith. So he's kicking us up another notch today. Praise the Lord. God bless. Shalom. God is good. I'm thanking him for where he's taking us and what he's doing for us. We're going to start talking even more today, dealing with the power of our praise and faith. We're going to praise him. I believe that when God started us out in this ministry, and he gave us even the name of our ministry, Word for Life Worship Center. A lot of places are called churches or so whatever, but he told us we are a worship center, so we are to worship him. A lot of people really don't know the difference between praising and worshiping. So we're going to be defining a lot of that as we go, because as we grow, we want people to understand what we mean in this city. We want people to understand where we're going, what we're planning on doing, how we are affecting the lives of the people that we come in contact with. But not only here, but we're on the internet. So if we go around the world, we want everybody to know, wherever we go, wherever this word goes, we worship God, the one true God. But we also praise him. We're going to teach you how to praise him in the midst of every situation, every circumstance, and learn what the power of your praise can do for you. Amen?
Amen.
Hey, I'm serious about this. Hebrews 11:1, in the Living Bible, I found this. I like how it says it. It says, what is faith? It is the confident assurance that something we want is going to happen. It is the certainty that what we hope for is waiting for us, even though we cannot see it up ahead.
Amen.
Isn't that something?
Yeah.
We're confident. We're assured that there's something that God has got for us. It's for us. It's got our name on it. His direction for us, where he's taking us, what he's doing for us. It's going to happen. It's a certainty that whatever we hope for, whatever whatever we're wanting in our lives, when we're believing Him for it, it's going to happen. Even though we cannot see it. Even though you may have tried to paint it on the canvas of your imagination, which you should do, because you have to really think about what you want before you get it.
Amen.
But even though you cannot see it, even though it's not tangible, even though you cannot feel it, that's what faith is all about. If you can figure it out, if you can feel it, if you can touch it, what do you need faith for? You don't. Anybody's ever seen God? Anybody ever touched God? So how do you know He exists?
We believe.
Come on now. That's what I'm talking about. That's faith. You believe. Psalms 105, verse 6 in the Amplified says, let everything that has breath and every breath of life praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Everything that has breath and every breath of life ought to praise the Lord. Because you are. Because you have life. You woke up this morning. You opened up your eyes this morning. You took a breath that you were conscious of. Man, God was dealing with me the other day. And I was like, Lord, that is just so incredible of how you created us. That even when we are unconscious, we are asleep. You are unconscious, meaning you are not conscious of your state. Your body is still working.
Amen.
Your mind is still working. Your brain is still working. It's regulating your breathing. It's regulating your heartbeat. It's still pumping the blood throughout your circulatory system. Your body is still working when you're not even conscious of it. That's God. Man, ooh-wee, that gave me shivers.
Mm-hmm.
To know that God has created me in this form, in this fashion, and He continues to watch over me, I got to praise Him. I got to praise Him because He's the one that does it all. I got nothing to do with it.
Amen.
It's God. Every single day, in every single way. Today we're going to study how the praises help our faith to be strengthened. And how faith will cause our praises to escalate. That's serious.
Yeah.
See, you got to know that your praise helps you in your faith. Because a lot of times things happen and you don't know. You can't see. You can't figure it out. But you ought to know that God is in the midst of everything. Your problems, your situations, the things that are good for you. Things that happen to you. Blessed things. He's in the midst of all of it. So that ought to help to strengthen your faith. And your faith, you continue to walk, get closer to God, believe Him more, trust Him more, that's going to cause your praise to escalate. You're going to be able to praise Him more and more and louder wherever you go, to everybody you see. Bless Him. That's how this goes. That's what we do. That's how we live, by the praises and our faith in God. Psalms 34, verses 1 to 4, in the New Life Version. It says, this is David speaking. He says, I will honor the Lord at all times. His praise will always be in my mouth. My soul will be poured proud to tell about the Lord. My soul's going to be proud to tell about the Lord. Everywhere you go, you ought to be like thumping your chest. I'm glad to tell somebody about the Lord. Let those who suffer hear it and be filled with joy. There's always going to be somebody out there who doesn't have what you have. I don't care if you don't think you got two nickels to rub together. Somebody ain't got two pennies. You got more than a lot of people do have. So they're in sorrow. They're suffering. They're going to be joyful when they hear you talk about the goodness of the Lord, of what He's doing for you. Give great honor to the Lord with me. Let us praise His name together. I looked for the Lord and He answered me and He took away all my fears. I like that. The more and more and more I study about these and look at these spirits that are plaguing the children of God. They are oppressing the children of God. Fear is one of the biggest spirits, I believe, that's out there. Mm-hmm. That's really jumping on God's people. Mm-hmm. Making them afraid. Mm-hmm. You can't walk right. You can't talk right. You don't know what to do next. You become so burdened down because you are afraid. And God has already told you, he's not giving you that spirit of fear. He's giving you love. He's giving you power. He's giving you a sound mind to what? Defeat that spirit of fear. And you've got to use it. Once you start defeating that spirit of fear, your praise is going to begin to really start to boil. You start to really feel God's movement in your life. You really start seeing how God works in your life to cause things to come together. Even though you cannot see them, they'll start to come together. You thought it was bad over here, but that bad over here actually was working for your good over here. And it all comes together to a crescendo that causes you to praise him. Giving him glory. Amen. Giving him the praise. Because yes. He's the one that did it. And you'll be able to see, because you can surely look around and say, I know I am. I had nothing to do with that. Mm-hmm. I just know in the world I could have done that. That was nothing but God.
Amen.
That's giving him
Amen.
The praise. A praise, according to Webster's. Oh, wait a minute. I'm sorry. Let me go back to Romans. I got Romans 1, 16 to 17 in the contemporary English version. I found this too. It says, I am proud of the good news. It is God's powerful way of saving all people who have faith. Whether they are Jews or Gentiles, the good news tells how God accepts everyone who has faith, but only those who have faith. It is just as the scriptures say, the people God accepts because of their faith will live. Because of their faith, you'll live. You won't just live, you will live. See, it's one thing to just live. Yeah. I mean, you just breathe, get up every morning, and, you know, you face the same old situations every day, and, you know, you get up, it becomes such a routine, you're in a rut. Get up, have a little breakfast, go to work, get messed up at work, come home, eat a little dinner, watch a little TV, go to bed. Now, come on now. I know good and well. That's, I done said that. A lot of y'all, that's your routine. Am I right?
Amen.
That's not living. That's surviving. He didn't say they will survive. He wants you to live. He wants you to have such a burning desire to do things, to love, to bless, to see. He's my God, I hear you, Lord. That is so good. God has put so many things in this earth for us to see, enjoy, and to experience. And we haven't begun to touch those things. Because we're so concerned with the cares of the world and what we want to do with our own selves and how we can make it, instead of relying upon God to take care of every situation and circumstance that he has put before us so that we can begin to lay back in his arms and enjoy the ride.
Come on.
To learn to live.
Right.
You haven't lived until you've really gone to some places and you've seen God's glory.
Amen.
In the majesty of this country. That's why Michelle and I, we go to the mountains every single year. I go, we have been to the ocean. That was awesome to stand at the edge of the ocean and to look, and that's all you see is the horizon and water, and know that thousands of miles away there's some more land. Mm. But you can't see it. Mm. You just know it's there. But God created that. Or be outside at nighttime. I'm not talking about in the city. I'm talking about go out in the country when there ain't no lights. And look up in a clear sky and see all the great majestic stars, constellations that are out there. Man, that blows your mind. See, we want to spend a lot of money on a lot of stuff, you know, that just don't mean nothing. Bring back a whole bunch of souvenirs that you end up in a box somewhere.
Yep. They don't buy them anymore.
And you know that. We don't even buy souvenirs no more. That don't mean nothing. I'd rather take a picture.
Yeah.
So I come home and it lasts longer. yep. and see God's glorious majesty. Yes. That's how he wants you to live.
Yes.
Oh, but it takes money. Well, who got the money?
God.
Is he the only one talking today? You know, he's talking the truth. I know y'all probably thinking the same thing too, but my brother's getting right on. Because God's got it. So if he's got it, you got it. Praise is to extol or lift up and glorify, to loud or to applaud and sing, to acclaim, honor, or to express approval. That's what it means to praise. See, praising God is not dependent on conditions and circumstances. Can I be governed by the outcome of situations, and it's not based on what you think or hope will happen in the future. Praising God is based on a total and joyful acceptance of the present as part of God's loving, perfect will for us. Amen. See, you can't plan on a praise, hoping and thinking that if God does something, then you'll praise him then. So you gotta learn how to praise God right here, right now, for the now, for what you're living in, what you're going through, good, bad, or indifferent. That's what praising God is all about. Praise is basic to our very salvation. If you are saved and you're not praising God, then you ain't living right. Mm-hmm. I'm not saying that you're living wrong. You ain't living right. Because you cannot be totally saved without praising God. Because number one, he delivered you from a life. He gave you opportunity to receive his gracious goodness. And he's given you hope for tomorrow, knowing that he will never leave you. He will never forsake you. He'll always be there. Too many people still live in that world of God don't love me no more. That's only because, number one, you haven't praised him enough to feel his presence. You have suppressed that spirit. Because you're living in a way that you cannot honor God. You've got to honor him with your praise. You've got to honor him with your faith. When you start doing that, then there's no more room for doubt. There's no more room for fear. There's no more room for hopelessness. It's God and God Almighty, full of grace, full of glory, ready to bless you. And you see that in everything that you do. We cannot really praise God without being thankful for the things that we're praising him for. Ephesians 5:20 in the New King James says, giving thanks always for all things to God the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Giving thanks for God for what?
Everything.
Everything. All things. Don't just thank him for the good stuff. Mm-hmm. You still got to thank him for the bad stuff that happens.
Amen.
You got to thank him for the trouble that comes your way. For we glory in tribulation. Mm-hmm. So you got to look at this stuff and begin to see how Satan wants to blind you mm-hmm. and only make you grateful yes. for what God yes. does good for you.
Yes.
But he's telling you, in all things, I didn't write that in your Bible. You need to open it up and see if it's printed in there. I didn't do it. God said it. All things. Psalms 95:2 says, let us come into his presence with thanksgiving. Why? Because you can't really be thankful without being happy and joyful about whatever you're thankful for. You got to be joyful and happy. Let us come into his presence with thanksgiving. Let us make a joyful noise to him with songs of praise. Glorious praise in all things. Glorious praise. In all things, thanking, giving thanks. In all things, no matter what it is. You got to praise him. You got to thank him in everything.
Amen.
I don't care how things look. We got people protesting. We got people marching. You got people upset, breaking windows, throwing rocks, acting fools because the person that they wanted to become the president didn't get to be the president. Wham, wham, wham. Sorry about your luck, Chuck. But where's your praise of God, who is still in control of everything? I don't care who's the president. God is still in control. Jesus Christ is still the king. He didn't give up his kingship. He didn't come off the throne. He's not bowing down to the president. The president still got to Jesus. Bow down to him. So what you got to protest about? Because life ain't going your way. It ain't supposed to go your way. You're supposed to go God's way. Oh, oh come on, man.
Right. Yes.
Jesus, you're supposed to praise God. You're supposed to give God the glory. You're supposed to lift up his holy name. He said, if I be lifted up above all the earth, I'll draw all men unto me. That's what you're supposed to do. You ain't got no right to stand up on nobody's corner and say, well, you know, I need to have all these rights. That means you're putting your trust in a man.
Yep.
Instead of putting your trust in God. And that's a problem. Praising them involves both gratitude and joy. When we're able to praise God for our circumstances, simply because we accept what the Word of God says is that we're supposed to praise Him in all things, we can soon experience the results of an attitude of constant thanksgiving and joy. I preached a sermon once, that's coming back around again. Attitude of gratitude. That's coming back around. Y'all can plan on that. Those of y'all that don't like me to redo another sermon, y'all just close your ears. Because it's like chili. Sometimes it's always good the next day. Yeah, man. Sat for a little while. Mailed together. So we're going to talk about that attitude of gratitude you're supposed to have. Because God wants you to understand and know that when you have that, you can turn your faith, it'll be strengthened, and you can continue to live that way. We just talked about living a life of faith. We're adding praise to that living a life of faith. Now you also got to praise. Yeah, I got to do that too. Yes, you do. That's the only way you're going to defeat the enemy. That's the only way you're going to be able to make sure that the enemy cannot bother you. See, you have to be able to fill yourself up with so much that Satan ain't got no room to come in between. You filled up every crack, you filled up every crevice with your praise and your faith. Satan ain't got no room. He's standing on the outside trying to break through. But my Bible tells me greater is he that's where? In me, in all of me, top to bottom, inside, outside, than anything that's in the world that could come against me. Praise is to be used in conjunction with your faith. So what is faith again? It's believing in God. Hebrews 11:6, in the Living Bible says, you can never please God without faith. Without depending on Him. Anyone who wants to come to God must believe that there is a God and that He rewards those who sincerely look for Him. That's what it's all about. That's faith. You can't please Him without it. He can't hear you without it. Because you ain't going to really call to Him unless you believe that He is. I heard a saying that always, I guess I don't know if it originated in World War II or Vietnam, but they say there's no atheists in foxholes.
Amen.
World War I.
Yep. All I know is when bombs start falling, whether you believe or not, first thing you're going to say is, oh my God.
Soldiers start calling.
Oh my God. Oh my God. God help me. Help me, Lord. Help me, Lord. Protect me, Lord. But you didn't believe in it. I do now. Praise is extolling and honoring God because of the thing that he does. See, worship, you worship God because of who he is. That's very simple. You worship God because of who he is. He's God. Like I said, he brought that to my mind. I'm like, Lord, even while I'm asleep, my goodness, man, you've created me and you've regulated this body that all while I'm asleep, even my nerves are active because I could turn over in my sleep when I'm in a bad position. But I'm not conscious. But my body knows. If it's too hot, I'll throw the covers off. I'm still asleep. But I wake up because I'm cold now. I got to put the cover back on. See, this is what God is doing. This is God.
Amen.
And you can talk about Big Bang all you want. You can talk about all the stuff that supposedly some high power is God.
Amen.
Created you so specifically.
Amen.
That's who you worship. And you praise him for the things that he does. We praise God not for what we expect will happen in or around us, but we praise him for where and how we are right now.
Come on.
Thank you. I have to go back to God delivering me out of darkness. My wife got saved, and she was going to a church. And I was not going to church. Had planned on going to church. Didn't want to go to church. I had my own way of living, and I was living there. And I didn't find this out until after I got saved. And God filled me and blessed me and all. But Michelle had gone to the pastor. She was complaining about how come he won't come to church with me. He won't pray with me. He won't this, that, and the other thing. You know, you know what that pastor told my wife? He said, you know, you need to stop. She said, you need to start praising God for your husband just the way he is right now. Those are the exact words he told my wife. Changed her whole perception. She started praising God for me, drug addict, womanizer, street runner, drug dealer. She was praising God for me just the way I was. She didn't ask God to change me. She didn't ask God to send me to church. She praised God for me just the way I was. God started talking to me. Because I wasn't hearing her. She could say all she wanted to say. I did start going to church with her, but I get high and go to church. That's bold, ain't it? And real bold. I think about it now, man, you was crazy. Everybody says, don't tempt the Lord your God, and that's all you did every time. I don't care. But God started dealing with me. When God started dealing with me, I couldn't deny anything he said.
Yep.
I couldn't deny his call for me. I could not turn from his love towards me. Had nothing to do with my wife because she did obedience. She praised God for me how and where I was right then. I'm here to tell you, for your children, for your mates, for your family members, anybody that you want to see saved, you start praising God for them the way they are right now. Praise God for them. Don't browbeat them. Praise God for them. Watch God start doing the work. Because I'm going to tell you, you can talk till your eyes get cross. Sometimes they won't hear words you got to say. Matter of fact, they become very belligerent because they get tired and you keep preaching to them.
Yep.
Yeah. Nobody.
The one voice you cannot deny is the voice of God. When God starts speaking, I don't care who you are, you're going to know his voice. You're going to have to become so enamored at how he chose you. Out of all the millions and millions and billions of people in the world, he talked to you. Jesus. I still get chills when I think about how he dealt me. But it all started with praise. My wife praised God. Now we started doing the same thing for our children. We're praising God for them. Father, I thank you for my children. They're not doing what I want them to do, but they are exactly where you have them right now.
Thank you,
and I know you're going to send a word that's going to deliver them, yes, bless them, nurture them, give them opportunity to bless. So I just thank you for them, Father. I praise you for them. I thank you because you're the God that delivered me. You're the God that I'm delivering them. I praise you, Father.
Thank you.
Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
To praise God is to delight yourself in him. Psalms 37:4 says to delight yourself also in the Lord, and he'll give you the desires of your heart. I think that scripture, I've dealt with that many times, because too many times we're thinking about the delight of our eyes.
Mm-hmm.
You kind of do it with what you see. What's in here? Your cardia, the place where God lives in you. What's the desires of your heart? What do you really want? Your will ought to line up with God's will. So that the things you want, you know, are the things God wants for you, and you can be able to get those things. We don't make a list of the desires of our heart and then try to delight ourselves in him so he can give us those things. Instead, we do just like Matthew 6:33 says, we seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added to you. You got to start to seek God in your praise. You got to seek him first in your worship. You got to know that he is in the position of granting what you need when you delight yourself in him. What does he want from you? He just wants your praise.
Amen.
He just wants your faith. When you start doing that, you delight yourself. This time, when, you know, I just got that kind of mind. I want God to be going, boy, that's my boy. Man, I can't wait to bless him with this, man. He just didn't let all. I love that kid. That's what I want God to say about me.
Amen.
That's what I want God to say about you. I love him so much. I can't wait to see them open up their eyes and see this blessing that they about to get. Because it's going to be so good. That's the God we serve.
Amen.
That's what we want to do for him. That's how he wants us to live. So in praising God, first we, number one, we admonish his love that draws us. We find this in Jeremiah 31:3. It says, long ago the Lord said to Israel, I have loved you, my people, with an everlasting love, with unfailing love, I have drawn you to myself. With love. We admonish his love. We have to know that, God, you love me enough. Again, out of all the millions of people, you call my name. We admonish his grace that saves us. In Ephesians 2:8, for by grace you have been saved through faith, and not of yourselves. You ain't done nothing to deserve God's grace. It is a gift of God. That's how you've been saved. It's a gift from God. We admonish his power to keep us. Isaiah 26:3 says, you will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on you because he trusts in you. We're talking about, you got to trust God. I don't care what things look like. I don't care how bad things seem. You got to trust God. God will tell you to do something, and you want to interject your thought process, yes, into it.
Mm-hmm.
By saying, well, but I still got to need this, and I still got to do that. And he's saying, trust me. Follow me. Love me. I'm able to keep you. We know that the only way that we can progress in the Christian life has got to be through faith. The power of our faith causes us to search the unsearchable and to believe the unbelievable. That's what the power of your faith does. There's so many things that you don't know. God wants you to search for truth and righteousness in everything that you come in contact with. So you got to start seeing people as God sees people, worthy of deliverance. I don't care if it's your worst enemy. I had somebody, I don't think I've said this before, I was teaching Sunday school, and I had one of my Sunday school students, I started talking about how, you know, it's not your boss, it's not your friend, it's not your parents, that's not your enemy. Your enemy is the spirit. So who are you fighting? You're fighting the spirit. So we got our relationships. I'm a happily married man, and I got a whole class of single, bitter women. That was my class. That was my introduction to Sunday school. Yeah, man. It was no joke. It was hard. I ain't gonna lie, it was hard. It was real hard. Because I had to tell them, you still gotta love. I don't care who it is that's hurt you. I don't care who it is that's harmed you. I don't care who it is that's talked about you. It's not them, it's the spirit. You got to love them. You got to pray for them. You've got to try to win them into heaven. And I had this woman tell me, I don't want that man in heaven with me. And I went to myself, ooh. My second thought was, well, with that attitude, what makes you think you going to heaven?
Yeah. Truth.
See, we've got to look beyond that stuff. We got to start seeing God's face in everything that we look for. And we got to start believing the unbelievable. I don't care what the world tells you it's supposed to be. God is saying it's different. World saying no, God says yes. Mm-hmm. I think somebody's written a thing where they say, you know, sometimes God's answer is no. And I challenge you, find that in the Bible. Mm. God has ever said no. I believe he said wait. I believe he's held it back because you ain't ready for it yet.
Right.
But other than that, he just hasn't heard your request because you have not delighted yourself in him. Or what you're asking for is not according to his will. So he can't hear you. You've regarded iniquity or sin in your heart. The Bible says he will not hear you. So you got to understand what God is telling us and learn to live according to his word. We have to learn how to live, to go beyond the limits of our finite mind. And it causes us to be able to conquer all the evil influences and forces that come against us. We must begin to realize that we have the power of the Holy Spirit that's within us to help us move those mountains. Did you know you're a new creation? You're a new creature? You are a child of the King. 1 Peter 2:9 in the New King James says, but you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, his own special people, that you may proclaim the praises of him who called you out of darkness and into his marvelous light. We are to be set apart. We are special. As we begin to walk this walk of faith and praise in him who has made us, then we begin to exercise more of our faith. And then our attitudes will reflect the Holy Spirit that is within us. We've got to know prayer, praise changes everything. It does. No matter how things look, I admonish you, I challenge you, in the midst of your hardest problem, your deepest sorrow, your toughest battle, I challenge you to start praising God for that situation.
Amen.
I don't have enough money to make my bills. Father, I praise you Number one, I got bills. Some people live off the grid. They didn't got nothing. You've at least given me something where I have a bill. I don't have enough money. God, I thank you that the money I do have, you've given it to me. I praise you for what you have given me. I trust you that whatever you tell me to do with this, I'm following your direction and not my own. And I know that you will be able to deliver me out of everything, because praise changes everything. Amen.
Amen.
We're going to praise him. We're going to be going over some more things. This is a series. We got some more to teach you about praise. But I guarantee you, when you get done with this, man, it's going to change your life. I guarantee it's going to change your life. It's going to change the lives of your loved ones. It's going to change the lives of your co-workers, your bosses. So you don't work for them. You work for God.
Amen.
You watch your children's lives change. You watch their respect and their love and their admiration for you change. Because you're going to start praising God more. He has a way of opening up the door and pouring you out so many blessings. So much so you won't be able to take them. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. I want to thank you for watching this video. I pray that you were blessed by it, that it encourages you to have a deeper relationship with God, that you continue to fight a good fight of faith and grow strong and courageous in your daily battles with the enemy. I encourage you to subscribe to this page, like us on Facebook, and log on to our website. There you can submit a prayer request and support this ministry through a financial gift. And remember, if each one can reach one, and a reached one can reach one, then a one will have one, and the kingdom will have been advanced one soul at a time. Thank you again, and God bless you.